Next up, we will hear from Local Networks USA on corporate climate leadership in the United States. On Side Stage 1, the panel will address the actions that Brazilian companies are taking to address climate urgency in the necessary ambition. Please welcome Adam Roy Gordon, the director of the Local Network USA.
Honorable guests in Glasgow and around the world, welcome to the U.S. contribution to today's Hybrid Business Ambition for Climate Action program. As other speakers at today's event and across COP26 have emphatically communicated, we are facing an existential climate crisis. The science is clear, the urgency is clear, and the business incentives are clear. UN Global Compact Network USA is hopeful for a meaningful political solution. However, we're not waiting for it. We can't wait for political solutions to solve this problem. Political solutions are necessary, but so is business leadership. And in the US, businesses are now moving faster than politics. The US business marketplace has a wide range of climate leadership. We, of course, have not just laggards as well, but companies whose business models rest on the foundation of environmental destruction and contributing to climate catastrophe. We also have truly leading actors in addressing this climate crisis, companies that are not simply aiming to mitigate the impacts of their current and future business, but also their historical impacts and enabling sustainable markets. We are seeing climate ambition in our financial markets, in our corporate innovation, in technology, product, packaging design, and supply chains across all 50 states. And this is being done regardless of politics, because there's no money to be made on a dead planet. Climate action is business imperative for business reasons, in addition to existential reasons. And the leadership of US business has impacts on the rest of the world and sets a standard for what is possible. US businesses are in many ways global businesses with impacts that touch every corner of the globe. While we are hopeful for political solutions from the halls of Congress and the desk of the president, the solutions that come from our financial markets, from our boardrooms, from our corporate executives will be equally, if not more, impactful. And in the US, as around the world, we must recognize that sustainability without equity is not sustainable. Corporate climate action not only represents an historical business opportunity, it also presents an opportunity to address the inequities in our economy as we design and innovate for a sustainable and equitable future. For our US contribution today, we have organized a panel to highlight those leaders and companies that are embracing the opportunities inherent in climate leadership. Each company has committed to science-based targets. And that is only the first step. We want to celebrate their leadership, of course, but what qualifies as climate leadership today will not be enough for tomorrow. Climate ambition must be ever increasing until we have at least ensured global emissions reductions aligned with the 1.5 degree pathway. This is a challenge posed to every company in the audience today. In the US, and in every country around the world. If your business success is contingent on your emissions, there is a fundamental flaw in your business model. Your quarterly profits come at the cost of our collective future, and additionally at the cost of the business agility required to navigate future profitability. And with that, it is my honor and pleasure to introduce our panel speakers today. I'd like to begin with our opening remarks from Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer.
Hi, everyone. This is Senator Chuck Schumer of New York, and I'm honored to join all of you for UN Global Compact's virtual event. To all of you watching, to all of our business leaders across the country, thank you for your science-based climate commitments to reduce greenhouse gas emissions and to help prevent the worst impacts of climate change. And I also commend the United Nations Global Compact for mobilizing businesses to tackle the climate emergency head-on. As we all know, the climate is changing in ways that are undeniable, that are accelerating, and that are devastating to community after community across America with increasing frequency. The consequences of climate change are already severe. Every time we face another major heat wave, it endangers the lives of millions of Americans who work outdoors or who don't have air conditioning. Every time another hurricane hits the East Coast or the South, it risks destroying people's homes and schools and churches and small businesses. Every time another wildfire rages in the West, it threatens our community and fills the air with poisonous smoke that entire cities breathe in. So the need for climate ambition from American business leaders is greater than ever. That's why your work here, showcasing action for a net zero economy, is so crucial. And that's why I'm fighting so hard in Washington to enact the bipartisan infrastructure bill and Build Back Better agenda into law, which together will deliver an unprecedented investment in clean air, clean water, clean energy, and resilient infrastructure to protect our most vulnerable communities from the ravages of climate change. We have an opportunity to take unprecedented action to protect America from these threats. And while there will still be so much more to do, Build Back Better is a bold step in the right direction. As the president highlighted before the world in Glasgow last week, our framework is proof that the United States is ready to once again lead by example against the greatest existential crisis of our time. And I'm confident American business leaders like yourselves will be among those leading by example for the country and for the rest of the world. While there is still much, much more work needed to protect our planet, I promise to be alongside fighting with you in the ongoing struggle against climate change.
Thank you, Senator, for those remarks. I'd like to now introduce our next speaker, Managing Director of CDP North America, Vitaly Ayala. Vitaly?
Hello, my name is Vitaly Ayala, and I'm the Managing Director of CDP North America, and it's my pleasure to have the opportunity to address you all today. I'll start with the obvious. There's no time to waste in solving the climate crisis. Climate change is knocking at our front doors. It is here, now, wreaking havoc on our lives and our economy. We need to see system-wide action, and we need to see it now, if we are to limit global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius. This month at COP26, we must see governments strengthen their nationally determined contributions and put in place roadmaps and policies to get there. But the change needed needs to happen at the speed and scale of business. The private sector has enormous potential to advance a sustainable economy. At CDP, we are tracking, benchmarking, and accelerating progress towards the goals of the Paris Agreement. We have been called the world's environmental report card, as we provide the largest and only comprehensive environmental disclosure platform for companies, cities, states, and regions, driving progress towards a net zero, water secure, deforestation-free world. And because of our work, we're in a unique position to spot the positive trends as well as the gaps within corporate climate ambition. So what are leading US companies doing to advance a sustainable future? Well, first, they are thoroughly disclosing their environmental risks, impacts, and goals. This year, over 13,000 companies disclosed through CDP, including 80% of the S&P 500. Since CDP's climate change questionnaire is fully aligned with the guidelines of the TCFD, or the Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosure, disclosing companies are providing their investors with data that allows them to allocate capital towards sustainable business practices, shifting investment dollars from a gray to to a green economy. A second positive trend, 338 U.S. companies have committed to or are already working towards science-based GHG reduction targets. And among those, 172 have taken the most ambitious step of committing to and setting 1.5 degree aligned targets. Lastly, and in addition to setting ambitious targets, leading companies are engaging their full value chains that include suppliers, customers, and other partners on climate-related issues like sustainable sourcing and reducing Scope 3 emissions. Earlier this year, CDP research found that supply chain emissions are on average 11.4 times higher than operational emissions, meaning that cascading ambition and action through your value chain is a huge piece of the puzzle. These signals of leadership are encouraging, but U.S. companies have much more to do to prevent dangerous climate change and environmental destruction. While it's heartening to see the recent wave of net zero pledges from corporations globally, just 30% of S&P 500 companies have committed to a science-based target. It is essential that companies have interim targets in line with 1.5 degrees C of warming, as well as robust transition plans for meeting those targets, and that they annually disclose their environmental data so that we can drive the accountability required to progress. Additionally, COVID-19 and social justice protests have strengthened calls to link the E and the S in ESG. Companies must continue to evaluate their roles in perpetuating environmental injustice and align sustainability goals with their overall social responsibility. And that starts by ensuring that the most impacted by the climate crisis have a seat at the table, and that justice and equity are centered in climate solutions. Businesses must ensure that climate change isn't isolated from other environmental issues, such as water security and deforestation, as they are all interconnected. If we don't immediately work to protect our planet's natural capital, its water, its forest, its biodiversity, we cannot limit global warming to 1.5 degrees C. Importantly, companies must advocate for sound environmental policy, using their influential corporate voice for good, and they must catalyze investment in the low carbon transition to accelerate it, mobilizing R&D dollars to find sustainable solutions that will propel their businesses into the future. As difficult as it will be, we have nature-based and technological solutions available, and we have capital that is ready to be allocated at a scale never seen before. Policymakers do have a big role to play, but again, the change required needs to happen at the speed and scale of business. It's not too late to build a thriving economy that works for people and planet in the long term. U.S. business has achieved inspiring feats of ambition many times before, from mass producing the automobile to manned space flight to the moon. You can lead the way with your ingenuity again, this time for an even nobler goal, paving the way for a safe and resilient future for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Ateli, for those remarks. I'd now like to introduce our corporate speakers for this session. We have four corporate speakers: Katie McGinty, CFO of Johnson Controls International; Anne Tracy, CSO of Colgate-Palmolive Company; Evan Harvey, Global Head of Sustainability at NASDAQ; and Carrie Adler, CEO of SkyPower Global. Thank you all for your remarks, and I'll let you take it from here.
Greetings from Johnson Controls. As we work hard to accelerate our action towards steep emission reductions, Johnson Controls would like to salute the many businesses that are driving action and leading the way. We are honored to be part of the Business Ambition for Climate Action. The fact is, 1.5 degrees C is an imperative, not a nice to have. The planet needs it. Our families and communities deserve and demand it. And the technology exists today to achieve it. So let's go get it together. At Johnson Controls, we are laser focused. Our business is buildings. We build operating technologies and digital solutions like our OpenBlue platform that make buildings safe, sustainable, and smart. Make no mistake, there is a lot of work to be done. Today, buildings account for some 40% of global greenhouse gas emissions. 75% of buildings are not green, and they will be around for decades to come. Meanwhile, the square footage of those buildings is expected to double. Every bit of this story is not sustainable. We need a new plan, and we need it now. Here's the good news. HVAC systems like our YZ chillers are some 30% more efficient than even the regulations require, and that's today. Our electric heat pumps can deliver 3 times the usable energy they consume today. When you add advanced controls in our OpenBlue digital platform, now you are driving very aggressively towards net zero. When you cut energy consumption and then add renewables that can talk to the grid through OpenBlue, you are transforming a building that is bad for the climate and the balance sheet to a clean, green asset that generates few emissions, but significant revenues. That good news story is possible today. And we are so confident of the result, we guarantee a climate positive outcome. That's what our net zero as a service is all about. We share the urgency. 2021 is a critical year for climate action. COP26 is the essential opportunity for decisive, determined government moves on policy and partnerships with business. Together, there is no doubt a climate crisis can be the catalyst to jobs, to growth, to ensuring healthy people and healthy places and a healthy planet. At Johnson Controls, we are all in. Let's get to work.
At Colgate, our purpose is to reimagine a healthier future for all people, their pets, and our planet. Achieving that future means we have an important responsibility to address climate change and its threat to disrupt every aspect of our lives. From weather events, water security and biodiversity, to food supply and socioeconomic stability. Accelerating action on climate change is therefore a priority among our stakeholders, including our employees, consumers, investors, NGOs, and our business partners. Colgate has made considerable progress to reduce our carbon footprint across our value chain since we began this journey in 2002. And this has been recognized by climate-leading organizations such as CDP, UN Global Compact, SBTI, EPA, and the US Green Building Council. Today, as businesses urgently embark on the transition toward a net zero carbon future, we at Colgate are accelerating our efforts by addressing both climate risks and opportunities. Our net zero carbon transition will address climate risks such as operational resiliency and future carbon pricing implications. We also see opportunities for progress from engaging with our supply chain partners on climate, creating a clear line of sight on climate investment valuations, and through the massive positive impact we can have through our products and our brands, especially since the Colgate brand is in more homes than any other. Accelerating action on climate change is a core component of Colgate's recently announced 2025 Sustainability and Social Impact Strategy, which aims to decarbonize our growing business. We are committed to reaching 100% renewable electricity by 2030 and net zero carbon by 2040 across our global operations. Beyond our operations, we have committed to 30% reduction of our supplier emissions and 20% reduction of our consumer product use emissions. Our targets align with the Science Based Targets Initiative, our signing of the Business Ambition for 1.5 degrees C, and our commitment to recover better, all working in concert with the UN Global Compact and other leaders. To achieve these targets, we are working across our entire value chain, supply, operations, and products to reduce and remove emissions over time. And here's a few examples of how we're doing it. First, we're engaging with our suppliers on climate, and that includes data collection, goal setting, and collaborative innovation for all the goods we procure. A great example of this is the climate and water work we are doing with mint farmers across the US. Next, we're working closely with our operations on the rollout of our 100% renewable electricity master plan, as well as LEED and True Zero Waste certifications at our global facilities. And finally, we're also working with our customers and our consumers. We are designing sustainable products and focusing on messaging, which helps consumers build healthy and more sustainable habits for life, such as Colgate's Save Water campaign, which has helped consumers avoid approximately 8.3 million metric tons of carbon by turning off the tap when they brush their teeth. With Colgate brand in more homes than any other, we feel the awesome responsibility and opportunity to have a positive impact on climate through our brands and our products. From encouraging consumer behaviors like turn off the tap while brushing to cutting edge sustainable product breakthroughs like our first of its kind recyclable toothpaste tube and our replaceable head toothbrush with 80% less plastic, we are finding ways to innovate and grow with a lower carbon footprint. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Evan Harvey, Global Head of Sustainability at NASDAQ, and I'm honored to address this body today to discuss our commitment to climate responsibility, advocacy, and innovation, and to extend my thanks to the fantastic UN Global Compact team and Network USA for the privilege. NASDAQ is more than just an exchange operator. Our market-making experience and innovative culture provides us with a unique and important perspective on environmental, social, and governance issues, or ESG, including economic issues that are inextricably tied to climate change. This position at the intersection of investors, companies, and regulators enables us to drive common sense sustainability discussions, empowers us to serve public and private companies, and emboldens us to create better solutions as our themed indexes, data and analytics offerings, and tradable asset classes like green bonds might attest. As a public company itself, NASDAQ is especially committed to advancing climate awareness and responsible performance by reporting its own efforts and continuously working to identify and socialize emerging trends. As a multiplier of best practices, both within our own operations and within our communities and with our clients, NASDAQ always endeavors to lead by example. We are strong believers in the materiality analysis process, which is a process and not an event, and through it we identify topics and stakeholders that drive our short and long-term corporate sustainability strategy. Our own reporting, as well as the reporting we recommend in the NASDAQ ESG reporting guide, is based on the Global Reporting Initiative framework, but we have added new disclosures from the Sustainability Accounting Standards Board, or SASB, for the first time. This year, we also issued our first Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosures report. The TCFD protocol, as you probably know, requires a deep dive into environmental performance, including a forward-looking analysis of the business impacts of a climate-altered marketplace and world. By examining the physical and transition risks posed by a changing climate, NASDAQ identified key challenges and will align its strategy to meet them. This report is detailed and public, so I encourage you to read further. NASDAQ is proud to be fully carbon neutral across the enterprise, including scopes 1, 2, and 3 for the third year running. And we work to find innovative, achievable sources of renewable energy and resource efficiency. Our recent commitment letter to the Science-Based Targets Initiative gives us 2 years to design and make public a series of climate-related performance goals. I hope to come back before this group at the next available opportunity and report our positive progress. We integrate sustainable practices into the ways we run our business and serve all of our stakeholders. And thus we aim to deliver positive impact outside the organization as well. In the most obvious way, we engage with our listed companies around the world on sustainability and climate issues, providing guidance, benchmarking, access to expertise, decision-making data, and other tools to make them more resilient, robust, and transparent. NASDAQ also leverages related initiatives such as our anti-financial crime solutions, our board and governance tools, and a robust and growing ESG advisory service. We have seen a significant increase in sustainable bond listings on our European debt market and launched the NASDAQ Sustainable Bond Network. Transactions in our NASDAQ-based ESG index futures recently reached 1 million contracts during the reported period. I want to highlight one more thing. Puro Earth, a unique B2B carbon removal marketplace. Puro Earth addresses the market impacts of climate change by leveraging essentially a market-based solution. Through CO2 removal certificates, companies can have access to help drive carbon removal methodologies at scale, including biochar, a stable, solid form of carbon that can endure in the soil for thousands of years, be used as a greenhouse additive in soil regeneration, also in wastewater treatment, and carbonated building elements, a sort of CO2 negative kind of concrete that actually removes more CO2 than its production creates. In this endeavor and others, we have been encouraged by increased market awareness, openness to innovative solutions, and rising client demand. NASDAQ is fully committed to meeting that demand, to improving its own performance, and leading the shift towards more sustainable and inclusive capital markets. Thank you.
Carrie Adler, I'm the Chief Executive Officer of SkyPower Global Group of Companies here at COP26 after day one. The only words that come to mind are hope. However, hope's not a strategy. It's going to take more. It's going to take action, meaningful action. Heads of states have the best intentions. They want to see this climate change crisis arrested in its path. The problem is that in order to accomplish that, we need to harness together not only the will and desire of the heads of state, but we need to harness humanity. Humanity has to act, has to do something that it's never done before. Akin to a lockdown during COVID, where dramatic changes were required to protect people's health. What's looming in 7 years from now is climate crisis unlike anything we've ever seen before. The question is, what can we do about it today? We can speak up. We can share what our feelings are. We don't want to be sitting here 7 years from now facing climate change square in the mouth, not knowing what to do then. Humans have a habit of procrastinating. We, as humanity, can no longer procrastinate. The signs are here. All the evidence is in front of us. What is there to question any further? This planet we call Earth, years from now, will not be a planet that we recognize. This isn't a doomsday prophecy. This is not a science fiction film. This is reality. Around the world, there's droughts. There's fires that are uncontrollable. There are countries who have never seen such extreme heats who are going to live at a time where climate migration is a way of life. This is not sustainable. This is not who we are as humanity. This is not what we promised the generations to come. Our children and grandchildren expect better from us. At SkyPower, we spend our time focusing on bringing real, clean, solar, renewable energy to the developing nations of the world in order to help them meet their climate change objectives, and more importantly, to provide basic electricity. Give those children, those families, a chance to be a member of society. Let their knowledge come out. Let them be a part of what we enjoy and what we call is life. The future of this planet is not us. It's the future of the children. It's their future that we're working for today. It's ensuring that humanity has a future where the sun can be spent outside during the day, enjoying yourself, not sitting there wondering if you're going to burn or if you're going to have enough water. We live in a time of crisis, and to sit here and do nothing is unacceptable. It's not just time to act, it's time to take actions, actions that are meaningful, actions that present an opportunity to change the way humanity has acted. Yes, we're not just going to go home and shut off electricity. That's not our nature. We must innovate. We must take measures that are necessary to curb the emissions. We must stop funding fossil fuel and must start funding this energy transition. Tomorrow cannot wait. Hope is all we have today, but it's not a strategy. As John F. Kennedy said, if it's not us, then who? If it's not now, then when? Well, today it's us, and the time is now. Let's use our minds, let's use our intelligence, let's use our wealth, let's use all the history and the science that we have today, and let's all work together to make a difference for a brighter future for the generations to come. Carrie Adler, COP21, now COP26. feels like 21, but it really is 26. Kerry Adler, COP26, day one in Glasgow.
Thank you to Adam, Senator Schumer, and the incredible panelists for the inspiring session. And Kerry, it is COP26, indeed. As we have heard today, the collective business ambition for climate action can help us reach zero carbon emissions by 2050. The UN Global Compact is committed to mainstream such leading corporate climate action, and we are ready to support through our local networks in close to 70 countries. Thank you again to the UN Environment Program and the UN Climate Change and the COP26 Climate Champions. And thank you again to our sponsors, Acciona, Biogen, and Russell Reynolds Associates. Please visit the UN Global Compact website for more information and take action through the Caring for Climate Initiative, the Water Resilience Coalition, and stay tuned for the 2022 Climate Ambition Accelerator launching early next year. And most importantly, we need credible pledges for action and accountability backed by science. The Business Ambition for 1.5 campaign and Science-Based Targets Initiative enable companies to do just that. By signing up to the net zero standard and committing to set a target in line with a 1.5 degrees Celsius and net zero future, our only future, your company can make its critical contribution to limiting the worst impacts of climate action breakdown. The links to these programs are in the chat on the left, on the right-hand side. As a reminder, all videos can be found on the UN Global Climate Global Compact YouTube page in the coming days, which is linked in the chat. Remember to keep the conversation going on social media, using hashtag our only future and COP26. It has been such an honor to be your host today. As thousands have kept their focus on Glasgow the past couple of weeks, I have hosted many leaders in the Scottish Highlands connecting with the land. We must reconnect deeply to our beautiful planet and value her resources. We can make a difference and we can achieve progress in caring for our collective Mother Earth as we vote for nature. Thank you and have a great day.